Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So as promised, we are in the part 2 of the Toyota Fortuner. We have the 174 bhp four-wheel drive variant with us today, and it produces 370 newton meters of torque. So that's pretty cool, amazing power output. So let's do a small walk around here. From the front you can see that the car itself is like evolved to be a Lexus kind of design. Pretty amazing in that sense. Really nice. The DRLs, as you can see, it's on now. I have switched on the indicators as well. The DRLs themselves, they are the 5 individual lights on both sides. They are on the headlight itself, so not much of a change there. You have the normal lights, which are white. They are the high beam as well, so that's also white, if you don't know. The car is in a grey colour, which is pretty unusual for a Toyota, but then it kind of like, you know, suits it. It's kind of different than other cars, so it's like a one-of-one spec here. That's another reason for that. I'll show you in like a minute. You have the fog lights down here. You have some grill. I mean, not a grill. You have a chrome treatment. You also get chrome treatment around here. It's a fairly small grill. It's not a huge grill, but then it's okay. This used to be black mud, but now it's like chrome. The owner has changed it. The bumpers themselves, they are, you know, wide as such. The ground clearance is huge, as you can see. Coming down the side of the car, now you can see the party trick. As I told you, this car has the alloy chains. It has a 20-inch rim. On both sides, we have 285/50 rubber. This car is also lifted using an Ironman spring. It's called Ironman spring. It is lifted by 4 inches in the back. In the front, it's not lifted because of aerodynamics. So, I don't know if you can see down there, you have Ironman kind of shock absorber kind of thing. So, it's like in the back, it's kind of like up, and in the front, it's down. So, that kind of works in the favor of aerodynamics. The car also has tints, which, you know, it's sportier. There's also sun reduction, very, very nice. Chrome door handles with passive entry. The indicators, you have indicators on the side mirrors as well. You have roof rails, which I'm not sure if it's functional. Coming around the back, you have Lexus. This is an aftermarket light. This has been changed. This is a Lexus style light with a dynamic swipe indicator. As you can see, pretty cool. Amazing. It's boxy. It's huge. It's humongous. Pretty nice. They had some cool stickers. Arab sticker over here. EXO. Drag 965. Amazing. I'll sit down. You have the spare wheel over there. Pretty cool. I'll show you the alloys more in closer. So, as you can see, it's like a forged alloy wheel. It's pretty amazing. It's 20 inches. It kind of looks small on the car because the car itself is pretty huge. As you can see, could have been a little bit more bigger, but this still keeps the ride quality intact. The OEM ride quality is still there. You don't feel much when going over through bumps. There's not much of a body roll in the car. Pretty cool, isn't it? Coming around the inside of the car. You get the regular Toyota infotainment system. The digital cluster, I mean the instrument cluster. It's not digital, it's analog. However, the design of the instrument cluster is pretty cool. On both sides, you have the RPM, you have the speedometer. On the center, you have a semi-digital speedometer. It portrays the speed. It also says the range, the reset buttons, the temperature, the mode that you're in, etc. You also get paddle shifters, which is pretty cool. You get the wiper controls on the left. You get the indicators on the right. You also get automatic headlights, which is pretty cool. You get the tweakers around here. You get a small clock, not a clock. It says the time basically. This infotainment system is not standard. It is changed by the owner. It's a Kenwood infotainment system. The car has subwoofer added to it. That's pretty cool. So this is a four-wheel drive. You can also change it partially into two-wheel drive, which then can be used to do burnouts. Pretty cool. This car does not get Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as standard, but the aftermarket system has it, which is pretty cool. The speaker system is amazing. With the subwoofer, the output is really cool. So you have the gears down below here. you have parking, reverse, neutral and drive. You can also slot it into sport mode, which then, you know, alters the acceleration, so you get more performance. Down here you get a glove box, which is pretty cool. I mean, not cool, but it is a decent sized glove box, not bad. You get the handbrake, which is a manual handbrake, it's not an electronic handbrake. You get the power mode here, you get the eco mode here, you get some storage space here to keep the keys. You also get some more storage space over here. The glove box, it's decent size, it's not huge, but it's okay. You also get some space over here. I like this space, it's cool. You also get some leather finish over here, some plastic materials over here. There's a small amount of leather over here. Nice, the steering wheel is beautiful. It's a three-spoke steering wheel with a wooden finish on top. That is pretty cool. The paddle shifter works amazingly well. You also get cruise control as standard. The finish is like leather with some leather stitching over here. That's cool. And you get your controls for the, you know, windows over here. You also get lights. I mean, door lights, front lights, which are white. That is pretty cool. And you have your space for the, you know, your sunglasses. You have a sunblind with a mirror and a light. Same thing over here. You also get this handle to get in and out of the car. That's pretty cool. The seats are amazing. It's like a brown color. Goes well with the exterior. It's pretty comfortable itself. This one is electronically adjustable. The driver seat, the co-passenger seat is not. But then that's fine. This is pretty cool. You can get in whatever position you want. You can get in comfortable. You can get in a sporty position. You can get in a view that, you know, we get good road view of whatever that's ahead. Let's go to the back. The back seat. This is a 7-seater. However, right now I've sat in the middle row. This is pretty cool. I have good knee room. Scooped out seat backs with some magazine holder. The head roof is decent. It's not a lot. I'm over 6 foot tall, but I should be fine. I mean, I am fine, but people over 6'3" should be a little bit cramped behind here. The center seat is all okay. My head is hitting. Okay, my head is hitting and my knees are hitting. So, but the cabin itself is white, so, you know, a child should be fine here, and adult is definitely gonna feel the, you know, crampness around here. You also get a 12 volt charging socket. You can use it to charge your phones. Automatic windows, everything. You also get a armrest. It's nice with some space. It's a cup holders, obviously. That's pretty cool. The back, the boot. I mean, I'll go to the back now. I'll show you the boot a little bit. So you get automatic tailgate, which is pretty cool. At this price point, you should get it, and it is there. It's amazing. So if you press this button, the boot will close automatically. The boot space itself, right now the last seats of row are reclined, so I can't show you that seat. But then if you recline it, the space is decent. You can fit in like two luggages here, a big suitcase, you won't have a problem. You also get this kicker subwoofer, it's pretty cool. Down here you get this Toyota mat. How do I open this? I'm not sure how to open that. But then, yeah, the spare wheel is down below, so that's that. You get some hooks over here, get some lights. Again, you get a 12 volt charging socket here if you want to use the vacuum. So if I press this button, it takes some time to close, but then it's decent. It's not the fast, but it's cool. It closes. Again, you get Fortuner written over here with some chrome treatment. That is pretty cool. You get reverse parking sensors as standard. That's also nice. You get a parking reverse light over here. You also get a shark foot antenna. Pretty cool at this price point. The total overlook of this car is pretty cool. It's definitely sporty, especially with the added rims and the suspension raised. It's amazing. It's definitely a one of one in the city. So, I think that's about it for this car. Please stay tuned for some more videos. Please subscribe, like and share if you found this video informative. And more videos coming to your way, so I'll see you on the next one. And a special thanks to my friend Sunny for lending this car. And yeah, I'll see you on the next one.